Ganesha turns Durasat into a statue. The gods decided to take Lord Ganesha's help to deal with Durasat. So they went to Mount Kailash and explained him the situation. "Help us, O Lord. You are our only hope against Durasat. You alone can destroy him," they said. Ganesha promised them that he would kill the evil demon. Ganesha then went to Mukund. He challenged Durasat for a fight. Durasat accepted the challenge. A violent fight ensued. Durasat fought with Ganesha using all his powers to defeat him. But all his weapons and powers were of no use. Ganesha could not be defeated. Soon Durasat understood that the invincible one he was fighting against was Lord Ganesha himself. But by this time, Ganesha hit him with his mace. Durasat instantly became a statue. The inhabitants of heaven and earth were delighted to be free of the demon's wickedness. Bhasmasura and Durasat. There is another story associated with Durasat. Once, Lord Shiva had blessed a demon named Bhasma that anyone touched by Bhasmasura on the head would be reduced to ashes. Armed with such magical power, Bhasmasura decided to test the boon on Shiva himself. Seeing this, Shiva started running to save his life. Ultimately, Lord Vishnu destroyed the demon. Durasat was Bhasmasura's son. He did what his father did, appeasing Shiva with deep penance. Shiva had granted Durasat the boon of immortality and absolute power over the three worlds, Trilok. Proud of his strength, Durasat started terrorizing the whole universe. Sage Narad wanted to destroy Durasat for his wicked ways and thought of a plan. He mocked Durasat by saying that he could not be called the ruler of Trilok unless he was the ruler of Kashi. As Kashi belonged to Shiva, Durasat could not take it over. Dhundiraj Ganesha. When Durasat heard that he could not rule over Kashi, he instantly hurried to attack Kashi. An anxious Narad reached Mount Kailash and narrated the whole incident to Parvati. Parvati was advised to give birth to a child who would then defeat Durasat, as he had a boon from Shiva that nobody but Shiva's son could kill Durasat. Narad also told Parvati to chant the mantra Om sincerely and soulfully. Parvati did as she was told, and an infant with four arms and a trunk was born. Parvati named the child Ganesha and asked him to kill the demon Durasat. Mounting the lion given by Parvati, Ganesha went to Kashi to defeat Durasat. As Durasat had received the boon of immortality from Shiva, Ganesha struck him down to the ground. It is believed Shiva built Ganesha's shrine on the spot where Durasat was buried. The Ganesha's idol established in this temple is called Dhundiraj Ganesha. Vedvyas needs a writer. Ganesha was not only a savior but a great writer too. He assisted sage Vedvyas in writing the great epic Mahabharata. Vyas was a great poet. He had split the Vedas into four parts: the Rig Veda, the Yajur Veda, the Sam Veda, and the Atharva Veda. After splitting the Vedas, Vyas decided to write the Mahabharata, which describes the great war fought between the Pandavas and the Kauravas, who came from the same family. There were many characters and different stories attached to the Mahabharata. Sage Vyas wanted to describe each and every detail, and also how Lord Krishna preached the lesson of the Gita to Arjun. But for this, Vyas needed someone who could assist him in executing such an extensive work. He wanted a person who was patient as well as wise enough to carry out the task without any break. Overall, he wanted a diligent writer.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.